السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وبه نستعين على أمور الدنيا والدين، والصلاة والسلام على أشرف المرسلين سيدنا ومولانا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين. اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد في الأولين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الآخرين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في المرسلين، وصل على سيدنا محمد في الملأ الأعلى إلى يوم الدين. رب اشرح لي صدري ويسر لي أمري واحلل عقدة من لساني يفقه قولي. اللهم علمنا ما ينفعنا، وانفعنا بما علمتنا، وزدنا علما وزدنا علما وزدنا علما. اللهم بارك لنا في تعلمنا وفي تعليمنا بركة تامة كما باركت على عبادك الصالحين. إلى حضرة نبينا محمد المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم، إلى أهل الخير وأهل العلم كلهم أجمعين. الفاتحة. أعوذ بالله من الشيطان الرجيم. بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، الرحمن الرحيم، مالك يوم الدين، إياك نعبد وإياك نستعين، اهدنا الصراط المستقيم، صراط الذين أنعمت عليهم غير المغضوب عليهم ولا الضالين. آمين. الحمد لله، الحمد لله رب العالمين. We thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala for this opportunity for us to be able to learn about the life of the blessed Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, peace and salutations of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala be upon him. We have been excuse me. We have been discussing about how the early companions, those who believed in Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the message that the Messenger of Allah, Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, was calling to, which is La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah. So the early companions, those who started believing Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam towards this call in the start of Islam, they, especially those who were weaker, those who were, did not have tribes or clans to protect them, or did not have prestigious fame or wealth, the weaker in this perspective companions were being victims, have been victims to the torture of the powerful, and the slaves, for example, which we shall be going into, Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah radiyallahu an, being tortured by the masters. Last week we discussed about the problems and trials that Sayyidina Abu Bakr as-Siddiq radiyallahu an faced, about the family of Yasir, the Ali Yasir, how the parents, both of them, became shaheed, and Yasir radiyallahu an himself eventually gave up. He couldn't stand the torture and hypocritically uttered words of kufr, of disbelief, which led them to let him go. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala descended the ayah, إِلَّا مَنْ أُكْرِهَ وَقَلْبُهُ مُطْمَئِنٌ بِالْإِيمَانِ, so that except for those who actually was forced to utter these words, but his heart is actually still in the tranquil, in the belief of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Moving forward, in our book Sirat Sayyid al-Bashar, number 4, we have Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah radiyallahu anh. He is a very famous sahaba radiyallahu anhum, one of the famous ashab, and also one of the names which has become known to be a synonym of the muazzin, the person who gives the adhan. Why? Because Sayyidina Bilal ibn Rabah radiyallahu anhu was the first person appointed to be the Mu'azzin. Subhanallah. For those who do not know, Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu an was a slave. He was a North African slave in Mecca. And he was amongst the first, the earliest of those who believed in Islam radiallahu anhum, among the companions. And when his belief was known by his master came to know about his belief in Islam, Umayyah ibn Khalaf, he started to torture. There came a point where all of the elites of the pagan elites, the Mushrikeen Mecca, they started to agree upon that before they could stop others from going into Islam, they should first deal with those who are around them, their families, their slaves. So amongst them was Umayyah Sayyidina, his Sayyidihi, his slave, Umayyah ibn Khalaf. And he started to torture Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu an, placing him on the ground, you know, making him lie on the scorching desert, on the ground of the scorching desert. So imagine, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, it is already hot, it was noon, it was the peak heat in the desert, the sun is baking from the top, and the ground is also heated from the bottom. And Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu was made to lie down without much clothing to prevent him from the heat. And on top of this already painful torture, Umayyah placed a boulder on Bilal radiallahu anhu's chest. Subhanallah. And he was threatening Bilal radiallahu anhu that you will continuously face this punishment, or you can either die facing this punishment, or you can disbelief in the deen, in the religion of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And what did Bilal radiallahu anhu respond? How was his response? Subhanallah. This is a point in Sirah Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, in the Sirah of Ashab radiallahu anhu, that always touches me. Bilal radiallahu anhu kept saying Ahad, Ahad, which means one, one. And what this implies is the oneness of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. La ilaha illallah Muhammadur Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Subhanallah. A boulder on your chest, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, not being able to take enough breaths. Now, if someone was to stand on you, would you be able to breathe? It would be very hard, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. And whatever breath he could gain, he would use it to say, Ahad, Ahad, subhanallah. Imagine the sacrifice Bilal radiallahu an gave for the sake of Islam, by showing his strength in his belief. In the end, Umayyah was approached by someone appointed by Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu an. Sayyidina Abu Bakr Siddiq radiallahu an sent one of his companions to Umayyah, proposing to buy Bilal radiallahu an from him, from Umayyah. And Umayyah, not wanting to lose face, because he would have to eventually kill this person so that he could maintain his face amongst the elites of the Mushriki Mecca. So he thought that he rather sell this person and get something out of it, and also save his face in the same while. And I mean, then let him die and not only lose face by failing to make him disbelieve in Islam, and also not gaining in money and losing his money for his slaves. Of course, back then slaves were valuable assets. So Umayyah sold Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu to Sayyidina Abi Bakr Siddiq radiallahu anhu, whom after that freed Sayyidina Bilal radiallahu anhu. Subhanallah. And if we were to analyze this actually, the freeing of Bilal radiallahu anhu actually caused more disgrace to Umayyah, because he was now a free man believing in Islam, openly announcing his belief in Islam, subhanallah. And this actually caused more disgrace to Umayyah, and people started to say that he couldn't control his slave, and now he let him free, and it's and he's doing whatever he wants, and Umayyah can't do anything about it as well. Subhanallah. Also, we have Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu an, the third Khalif, who would become the third Khalifa of Islam. When his uncle Al-Hakam ibn al-As Al-Hakam ibn al-As came to know that his nephew Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu an accepted Islam, embraced Islam, he tied him up. He tied him up, trying to persuade him or force him out of Islam, but eventually failed when he saw the persistence of Sayyidina Uthman ibn Affan radiallahu an, and eventually he let him go. And also we have Sayyidatina Zinnirah radiallahu anha, who ended up being blind because of the tortures she faced. Sayyidina Khalid ibn Sa'id radiallahu an was tortured by him being beaten up, and also by not getting enough food. He was prevented from food supplies. Sayyidina Al-Khabbab ibn al-Arat radiallahu an, he was tortured by heat as well, by kneeling. Sayyidina Abu Fakiha, he was also tortured by choking him and with heat. Sayyidina Mus'ab ibn Umair, by imprisoning him. Sayyidina Az-Zubayr ibn Awam, by also not only imprisoning him, but also smoking him, choking him with smoke. Subhanallah. See, so the list goes on, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. What we are trying to understand from these incidents is that Islam didn't come to us today out of ease, out of the wealth that some people have misconcepted to. Islam started with a lot of sufferings, a lot of sacrifice, a lot of patience that helped them to hold on to Islam because of their belief, because of the tranquility they found in believing in one true God, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam. One true God who was the most powerful, who was able to hear them, who was able to accept their prayers, who was capable and powerful enough to do whatever he willed, and no one can stop him. The tranquility that they gained in believing in such a God, instead of believing in God in idols, who people were fighting upon each other, who was being powerful or who was more powerful than the other. Subhanallah. This tranquility gave them the strength to be patient, to face all of these sufferings and tortures that eventually, if it weren't for their persistence and their strength of the iman, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if which we have to take lessons from, Islam wouldn't have reached us. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, especially, so this is during the start of Islam. Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam also mentions that during the end of times, which we are also finding ourselves in, according to the signs of Yawm al-Qiyamah, Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam said that Islam will become very hard to hold on to, that a person must hold on to Islam by his molar teeth, just as a dog holds on to its meat with the back of his teeth, which is the most strongest part of our jaw. Of course. So my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, if and when we were to find ourselves in hard spots, in difficulties because of our belief, my dear brothers and sisters in Islam, go back and read about the sufferings, the pain that our beloved companions of Rasulullah sallallahu alaihi wasallam went through for them to be able to hold on to their religion, and we would find support, moral support, and we would also understand that what we are going through is actually nothing compared to what the Ashab radiallahu anhum went through. My dear brothers and sisters in Islam, inshallah, we have come to the end of today's lesson. We shall continue our lessons as we have been doing for the past year. Next week, inshallah, we shall be discussing about the stories of how some of the famous Ashab radiallahu anhum, how some of the companions radiallahu anhum came into Islam, which caused great benefit inshallah, we shall be discussing more about the interesting incidents about the life of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wasallam. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala keep us steadfast in this path of learning beneficial knowledge and benefit us with the knowledge that He has blessed us with. Ameen, ameen, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, subhanakallahumma bihamdik, ashadu an la ilaha illa ant, astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayka, bismillahir rahmanir rahim, wal asr, innal insana lafi khusr, illa alladhina amanu wa amilu salihati, wa tawasaw bilhaqi, wa tawasaw bilsabr. Ameen, alhamdulillah, rabbil alameen, Allahumma salli ala sayyidina Muhammadin wa ala alihi sahbihi jama'in. Allahumma arina al-haqqa haqqan warzuqna ittiba'ah, wa arina al-batila batilan warzuqna ijtinabah. اللهم أحينا على الكتاب والسنة ومتنا مع الإيمان والتقوى وجعل آخر كلامنا عند الموت قول لا إله إلا الله توفنا مسلمين توفنا مسلمين توفنا مسلمين وألحقنا بالصالحين ربنا تقبل منا إنك أنت السميع العليم وتب علينا إنك أنت التواب الرحيم آمين برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين وصلى الله على سيدنا محمد السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته